understand how to solve blood type related problems. According to the ABO blood grouping, there are four blood groups, that is A, B, AB and O. The ABO blood grouping has three genes, that is gene A, gene B and gene O or gene H. The genes A and B are dominant, whereas the gene O is recessive. We know that we have two alleles for each gene. So, the blood groups, the four blood groups actually have different genotypes wherein they have the two alleles. So, blood group A phenotype has a genotype of AA or AO. This is the homozygous type and this is the heterozygous type. Since A gene is dominant over the recessive O gene, the genotype AO shows the phenotype of type A blood group. Similarly, a blood group B phenotype individual can have a genotype of BB and BO. And a blood group AB phenotype individual can have a genotype of AB only. Similarly, a blood type O individual has only one genotype, which is OO. The genotypes can also be written in a different way, wherein gene A is represented as IA, gene B is represented as IB, and gene O is represented as small I. So, if I want to write the genotype right now, OO will be written as II, AB can be written as AA, IA, IB, BB can be written as IB, IB, BO can be written as IB, small I, and so on. Let us start with the simplest example of type O female marrying a type AB male. What will be the probable blood type of their progenies? Now, you need to understand that the question only mentioned the phenotype of the parents and not the genotype. However, we saw that there is only one probable genotype for the phenotypes AB and O, which is AB and OO. Thus, we know that the parent genotypes are AB and OO. If we will draw a Punnett square for these parental genotypes, that is genotype AB and OO, we will end up with genotypes AO, BO, AO and BO. We get two AO blood genotype, which is blood type A, and two BO genotype, which is blood type B. Thus, from a AB and OO blood cross, we get 50% of blood type A and 50% of blood type B progenies. This was the most simplest type of problem because both phenotype AB and phenotype O has only one particular genotype, that is AB and OO. So there was no difficulty in solving this problem. What will be the progeny from a father with heterozygous type A, that is blood type A, and a mother with homozygous type B, that is blood type B? Now the father can either be a homozygous or a heterozygous type A. Similarly, the mother can be a homozygous or a heterozygous type A. But in the question, it is mentioned that the father is heterozygous, which means he is AO genotype, and the mother is homozygous, which means she is genotype BB. If we draw a Punnett square with the genotype AO and BB to look at the genotype of the progenies, we get genotype AB and genotype BO. Genotype AB will give us a phenotype of AB and genotype BO will give us a phenotype of B blood type. So, there are chances, 50% chances of getting a AB phenotype and 50% chances of getting a B phenotype with these parents. In a hospital, someone removed the label from three newborn kids having blood type AB, A and O. The hospital must find the correct parents. So the question is actually wanting you to identify the correct parents. Now the question states that one of the three mothers is homozygous for blood type A, which means she is a genotype AA, and her husband is type O. We know type O individuals have only one genotype, that is OO. If we draw a Punnett square for these two parents, we will end up with all AO genotypes. AO genotype means that the phenotype of the offspring is possibly A. So we know that all their offspring, all their children will be of A blood group only. There is no other possibility. Thus, this particular couple has a child which is of A blood group. Now, if we had to find out for the other two children, we will have to look at the blood groups of these children, and similarly we will have to construct a Punnett square and find out what are the probable genotypes and if they are matching with the parent or no. Mr. and Mrs. Jones have a blood type B. They have 12 children, out of which 3/4 kids have blood type B, 1/4 kids have blood type O, and we have to find out the genotype of Mr. and Mrs. Jones. What we know over here is both Mr. and Mrs. Jones have a blood type B, which is their phenotype. That genotype can be either homozygous BB or heterozygous BO. We need to find out what is the probable genotype. The next thing we know is that both of them have 12 children. Out of these 12 children, 3/4 of the children have a blood type B. So 3/4 of 12 actually accounts to 9 kids. So 9 children are having blood type B. And we know that 1/4 kids have blood type O. So 1/4 of 12 is actually 3 children. So 3 children have a blood type O. So we get a 9:3 ratio, which is actually equivalent to a 3:1 ratio for blood type B and blood type O. There are three possible genotypes of the parents. Either both Mr. and Mrs. Jones can be a homozygous BBBB, or one of them can be BB and the other one can be BO, or both of them can be a heterozygous BOBO type. Now, what information we have now is we get a 3:1 ratio of blood type B and blood type O. So now what we can do is we can try all of these three crosses and we can see which of the three cross is giving us the 3:1 B by O ratio. Now if we look at the first condition, here there is no O gene at all. So in this condition, all B type children will be obtained. So we already know that BB and BB is not the genotype. We will look at the second condition. Upon drawing a Punnett square for the second condition, we observe that even over here, we get all B type children. So even the second condition is not true. We will look at the third condition, wherein both the parents are heterozygous, and over here we can see that we get three genotypes with blood type B and one genotype with blood type O. This is actually satisfying our 3:1 B by O ratio. This means that Mr. and Mrs. Jones both have a heterozygous BO genotype. Let us now consider problems involving the Rh factor. The Rh factor has two phenotypes, that is Rh positive and Rh negative. We know that one phenotype is dominant and one phenotype is recessive. Here, the Rh positive phenotype is dominant and the Rh negative phenotype is recessive. There are two possible genotypes for the Rh positive phenotype, that is plus plus and plus minus. And the Rh negative phenotype has only one possible genotype, which is minus minus. This question states that the father of two children is type O plus and the mother is type A plus. The children's are type O minus and A plus. With this information, we need to find out the genotype of the father and the mother. Since the father is a blood type O, he will have a genotype of OO. However, since he is Rh positive phenotype, he can either be a plus plus or a plus minus genotype. The mother is a blood type A, so she can either be AA or AO. Also, she is A positive, that is Rh positive phenotype, so she can be plus plus or plus minus. Now, looking at the kids, we have one kid who is O minus. This means that the child has a genotype of OO and minus minus. We know that the child gets one allele from the father and one allele from the mother. Since the child is OO, one O came from the mother and the other O came from the father. The father is OO and the mother can be AO. It is only then she can contribute one O for this kid. So, we know that the mother has a genotype of AO. Now again, this kid is minus minus, which means both the parents have contributed one minus. In that condition, both the parents should have a genotype of plus minus plus minus. It is only in this condition that they both can give 1-1 negative to obtain this O negative child. So, the father has a genotype of OO and plus minus and the mother has a genotype of AO and plus minus. If this video was helpful, then please like this video, share it with your friends, subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to leave us your valuable comments. Thank you.